So good day and welcome back. So today we're going to talk about the last chapter in electrostatic, which is electric potential. So before we move on, I would like to share a Telegram channel which I found. So it has the notes, trackables, and some useful link for the STPM physics students. So you can also discuss with your peers in the Telegram channel. So you can join the group by scanning the QR code, or I will provide the link in the description below. So at the end of this video, students should be able to define electric potential, explain the meaning of equipotential, use the relationship between E and B, and finally use the formula of electric potential energy U. So first, we begin with the electric potential due to a point charge. So it is defined as the work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to a point in an electric field. So we have learned that there's electrostatic force acting on the blue charge. So when we say that we're bringing the point charge nearer to the source charge, we say the work is done along the distance it moves. So we know that electrostatic force is inversely proportional to the square of distance. So we can actually find the work done by determining the area under the graph of F against the X by using the method of the integrations. So integration of the F with respect to X from infinity to R. So the force applied on the point charge is actually should be the same as the electrostatic force, but in the opposite directions. So this is why when we apply the integrations, the F here is the negative of the formula of electrostatic force. So by doing the integrations, so in the end, you will get the work done is equal to QQ divided by 4 pi epsilon R. So by putting the formula of W into the definitions, where V equal to work done divided by Q, so you would get that the electric potential is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R. So next, we move on to the charge sphere, which we have learned about it in the last video. So the E field around the charge sphere has similar trends as point charge, except it has zero E inside the sphere. So since E is zero inside the sphere, so there is no electrostatic force inside the sphere. So when we are moving a point charge from infinity to a point inside the sphere, so when we do the integrations of F respective to distance, so we will split the domain into two parts, which the first one is from the infinity to the surface of the sphere, where the force applied on the point charge is the same as the electrostatic force, but in the opposite directions. And then the second part is from the surface of the sphere to the inner of the sphere, where the F is zero. So continue the integrations, you would get the work done is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R. So for the electric potential, so first we look at the outer of the sphere, where the formula of the V is the same as the point charge. But when we are moving the point charge nearer to the point charge, where the distance is less than the radius of the sphere, so we will see that the V is equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R, and the value of the electric potential is constant. This is because that the point charge Q and the radius of the sphere is fixed, and it does not change with time. So next, we're going to look at the potential difference, which is almost similar as the electric potential. So since both of them have same scope, students might get confused sometimes. So first, we compare the definitions. So for electric potential, we have learned that it is work done from the infinity to a point in an electric field. But for the potential difference, it is from a point to another point against the electric field. So here we could see that the starting point of moving the positive charge is actually different for both of them. So electric potential, since it is from infinity to a point electric field, so the work done is calculated based on what we have learned just now. But for the potential difference, to calculate the work done, it is the integration of F respective to X from a point R1 to another point R2. So we could see that the starting point here is different. So furthering the integrations, so we will get V for the electric potential is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R. But for the potential difference, the V will be different here. Since the R1 is not infinity, so we have a value at the end of the formula. So in short, the V here can be summarized as V equal to V2 minus V1, which reflects the meaning of the names for the potential difference. It is, you can understand it as the difference between the electric potential of that 2 point. Next, so after we learn that the work is done to move the point charge from one point to another point, so there's a special case which is about the equipotential surface. So it says that all the points on the equipotential surface have equal potential. So the reason here is that we can see that the distance between the source charge from any point on the surface have equal distance. So when you move the point charge from one point to another point which is on the same surface, it says that the value of the distance is not changing. So the work done is zero. So another way to see it's about the formula of V, where V is depending on the distance R. So since R doesn't change, so the electric potential at any point on the equipotential surface is equal. So when we move the point charge between equipotential surface, so we can see that the value of the distance is changed from R1 to R2. So there's work done here. So there's a potential difference between the two equipotential surface, which is equal to V2 minus V1. So in short, when the point charge is moving around the equipotential surface, it says that there is no work done. So next, we're going to look at the relationship between V and E. So we learned the formula for V and also the E. So E is the differentiation of V respective to X. So substitute the formula that we have learned just now, we could get the E equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R squared. So by looking at the graph of V against the X, we can obtain the E by calculating the gradient at a certain point that we are interested in. So next is about the V. So E is the integral of E respective to X. So doing the integration, we could get V equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon R. So V can be obtained by calculating the gradient under the graph of E against X. So lastly, we look at the electric potential energy. It is defined as the work done to bring the charge Q from infinity to a point in an electric field. Sounds familiar? So recall back the electric potential, it is the work done to bring a unit positive charge. So electric potential energy is referring to the actual charge. So we say that the formula for electric potential energy U is equal to QV equal to QQ divided by 4 pi epsilon R. So that's all for this video. Thank you.